Morning, children. Now today we are going to see about third standard social unit 3. The lesson name is panchayat. Okay. So you know what do you mean about the panchayat system and understand the panchayat provides the basic facilities to the village people and to know about the duties of gram sabha, to know about the local self government. So about the panchayat system is only in the village. So, like the, in this panchayat system only, we are going to see about what all they are doing in the village. So, in panchayat means, you are seen in villagers, they will put dandora. Whatever they want to give the announcement, they will put the dandora and inform any news, they will inform through this information, they will give the information. Here, in page number 147, see the page number 147, dandora announcement. In this, one man is putting the dandora. Dandora na and the idu pannuvanga. Molo mari adichi, they will call. So, on the satyate keta, all the villages, people in the villages will come out. Okay. And you understand? They will come out and they will see what announcement they are going to give. So, a special Gram Sabha meeting will be held on Independence Day. So, what that man is telling? A special Gram Sabha meeting, that is the village means Gram. So, the Gram Sabha, they are going to have one meeting. On which day? Independence Day. Okay. All the villages are requested to participate. So, on the village, all people are requested. Ketu kolgirom. Kalandu kolumar, ketu kolgirom. Requested to participate. Adla vandu, ellarum and the Gram Sabha meeting ku varano. This is the Dandura announcement given by man in the village side. Okay, children. So, after hearing the announcement, see the next page, children. There's a conversation between the Indian and the dad. So, what Indian is asking is that after hearing the announcement, avan the announcement ketadukaprom, Indian rushed towards his home. So, avan veetukum vegama porana. Can you understand? After hearing that announcement, Indian rushed towards his home. What he is asking to his dad? Indian is asking, Dad, what did the Dandora announce say? What is the Dandora announcement? Dandora announcement. What did the Dandora announcer say? What Indian is asking? Dandora announcement. What Dad is saying? He announced that a special Gram Sabha meeting would be held on Independence Day. Oru mukhyamana Gram Sabai kootam. Gramathla oru kootam kooda poranga. Adhu enneke on Independence Day. Abdin solranga. His dad is telling that. Indian, what is Gram Sabha meeting? What is Gram Sabha meeting na enna? What will they do in the meeting? So the meeting la enna pannuvaanga? Abdin is asking. Okay. So father is replying, Dad, people of our village assemble together and discuss the roles of the panchayat board. So, people of the village people, they will assemble together. Na, ellara onra kooduvargal. Assemble together. Ore edathla koodrathu. And discuss the roles of the panchayat board. Panchayat board moolama enna na pannalam. Enna na and the panchayat board la village people ku seiya mudiyum. And discuss the roles of the panchayat board. Panchayat board la the grama makkalukku and the gramathukku enna na seiyalam abindrathu. Discuss. Kalandu alosikar ellarum seindhu. Indian. Oh, I see. What is meant by panchayat board then? Okay. Appa panchayat board na enna? What do you mean by panchayat board? Okay. Now can you understand children in this page? So after hearing that announcement, Dandora announcement, Indian is asking what did the announcer say? So what the announcer said? He announced that special Gram Sabha meeting. Dandora announcement edha pathi? Special Gram Sabha meeting. Gramathla oru kootam kooda poranga. Gram Sabha meeting will be held in that panchayat. Can you understand? Gram Sabha meeting. On which day they are going to conduct this? On Independence Day. Okay. Indian is asking, what is Gram Sabha meeting? Gram Sabha meeting, what will they do in the meeting? His father said, all the people in the villages will assemble together and discuss about the roles of the panchayat board. Panchayat board vandu people ku enna na seiyalam enna na vasadigal illa adu eppadi yerpaduthi kudukalam, that only they are going to do. Okay, what is panchayat board? So the panchayat board moolama inga what they are going to do in the for the people and the village. So what is meant by panchayat board? What is panchayat board? Panchayat board na enna? What is meant by panchayat board? What is meant by panchayat board? What is daddy's telling? I am so glad about your questioning. Kelvi kekkadhu enakku romba yepa irukku sandoshama irukku, glad, very happy. Let me tell you about panchayat. Okay, let me tell about the panchayat patti solren. You just listen. Our country is a vast country, is a huge country, periya country, our country. It has towns and villages. So our country is a very big country, huge country. So there are so many towns and villages. Therefore, many panchayats must exist. So and then the towns ko villages ko panchayat irkano. Over village ko panchayats must be there in towns and villages. Village panchayat is the root of panchayat system. So village na gramathla or panchayat panchayatun irupanga. Enna or kuraigalo, enna or thagararo, enna or prachnaigalo da ore panchayat koodi anga vandu avanga da theerthirupanga. That is village panchayat. Is the root of the panchayat system and the panchayat system and the village level and the anga vandu. It provides the basic facilities to the village people. So village people ku adipadai thevaigal enna na idu thanni venum iruka idam irukada and then payir velayathukku enna mari idu pannanum. So all this they will say in the book. The 73rd constitutional amendment act came into force in April 1993. 73rd constitutional amendment act. What is panchayat board? Panchayat board na enna sonna? Panchayat board. So panchayat board is a so village panchayat is the root of the panchayat board. Village panchayat system is the root of the panchayat board. Is the root of the panchayat board. So there are so many towns and villages. So each town and village must need the village panchayat, and this is the root cause for the panchayat system. The 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act. 73rd Constitution. This is one law. This Constitutional Act, Constitutional Amendment Act, they passed one law. So in April 1993. Came into force. 73rd Constitution, that means one law they passed. What is the law? The salient features of 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act is the three-tier system of Panchayat Raj. So Panchayat Raj, what is the law? What it features? It features a three-tier system. The three-tier system of Panchayat Raj, and the Panchayat Raj is a three-tier system. Three-tier system, they got it. Salient features is a mukhyamana idu vandu three-tier system. Panchayat are set up in every village in 500 people and above. So ovvoru panchayat liyum eppadi idu pannanga, they must have the 500 people. So 500 people more than above, 500 people above in the panchayat. So panchayat onu aarambikkanona and the village la there must be 500 people and above in the village. So the 500 people and above na and the edla panchayat must be started. So there is a three tier system. Three tier system na moonru adukku, three steps. What is the three steps of the panchayat system? District level, block level and village level. So three tier system in panchayat raj. System of panchayat raj. What is the three size system? The first one is district level. First tier is district level. So in this district level, that will come as district parishad. District panchayat. That is Zilla Parishad. District Panchayat is the Zilla Parishad. And then block level. Next one is block level. In this block level, Panchayat Union. Block level second system is the second tier is the Panchayat Union. In the Panchayat Union, you will get Mandal Parishad and Panchayat Samiti. Mandal Parishad and Panchayat Samiti. Okay children, first level is the district level. In that district Panchayat, that is Jilla Parishad we can say. And block level is the Panchayat Union, Mandal Parishad or Panchayat Samiti. That is the second tier. And third tier is the village level. Third tier is the village level. In this village level, village Panchayat or Gram Panchayat. We can say village Panchayat and also say Gram Panchayat. Okay children, so the three tier system in Panchayat Raj is district level, district panchayat or as well as Zilla Parishad. In block level, Panchayat Union, Mandal Parishad or Panchayat Samiti. And in village level, village panchayat and Gram Panchayat. So this is the three tier systems in Panchayat Raj. Okay, now who are all in the village panchayat? So in the village panchayat la yaar yaar la irupanga, now we are going to see village panchayat one. So village panchayat la who are all will be there? What is telling? There is a president. President is the head of the panchayat, thalaivar irupanga, and a vice president also will be there, along with the ward members. 6 la irundhu 15 members varaikkum there will be the vice president, president along with the ward members. How do the panchayat members are selected? Village people select the president and the members through the election. So, the village people can enna pannuvaanga, they will select the president through the elections. The tenure of the members of panchayat is 5 years. So, ivanga evlo varsham varaikku irukalam? 5 years they can do for the village people, work for the village people. The vice president is elected by the ward members. Vice president vandu ward members irukanga illa 6 to 15 members, they can select the vice president. But president select pandrathu the village people, they through the election only they will select. Can you understand children? So the president is the head of the village panchayat. So president only, president is the head. He was elected by the village people through the election, elected through village people through election. So election mulama village people nammalku irukkeliya elections vote podringa, like that the village people will vote for the president and they will select through the election. And how many ward members will be there? And for vice president was elected by the ward members. Vice president elected by the ward members. So ward members, how many members will be there? Ward members when the 6 to 15 members will be there. Ward members. So under ward members now 6 to 15 people will be there. So this ward members only will elect the vice president. Ivanga vandu election moolama varamaatanga, they will only ward members will select. 6 to 15 members select panaka he will become the vice president. But president vandu through the election only he will be selected as a leader through the election. Okay, so there president and the tenure of the president is 5 years. So for 5 years they can rule the village as a president. 5 years they can rule. The tenure time period is 5 years. Okay, now in Kudavole system, in the traditional method of election, in a traditional method enna pannaanga Kudavole system. How they started the Kudavole system? Village people gathered and wrote the names of the preferred candidates in the palm leaves and kept them in a mud pot called Kudam. So they will write the member who voting in. Now we can see if you want yaar pedikadhu enna colors select pannum, you will write some of the colors and ask one of the members to select it. So like that the village people gathered and they will write the name of the preferred candidates and the candidates nikkraanga illaya avanga name vandha and the panavole palm leaves means panavole la ezhudhi and they kept them in a mud pot vechirpaanga. So and the mud pot la and they ezhudhi and the oley la potruvaanga. A child was called to pick up the palm leaves one by one. So or leaves vandha or child kooptu and the palm leaves one one edukka solluvom paakumbodhu the persons whose name in palm leaves was declared as a elected. So the palm leaves la yaarude per adhigama irukku avanga vandha he was elected as a leader in the Kudavole system. This is called Kudavole. Kudam naka mud pot. And the mud pot la and the ole la name ezhuthi potuttu adukapra elect pandradha Kudavole system. Okay, now what are the duties of these members? Okay children, so we have got 8 duties. What are the duties? Duties of village panchayat. Duties of what are the duties of these members? What are the duties they will do? What that is telling, that duty is to provide basic needs of the villagers. So village people, the enna na adipadai thevigal, basic needs. That is the obligatory functions of the villagers. Obligatory is the important mukhyatvam vaindha. Okay, if obligatory functions of the panchayat are, first one is providing electricity and street lights. They have to provide electricity and villages and all, there won't be like the street lights and they have to maintaining that. So providing electricity and maintaining the street light, that is the first duty of the panchayat, maintain the street lights. And the next one is drilling and maintaining of the village wells. So kinaru thondrathu drilling and maintaining. So drilling the wells, drilling and maintaining the wells, you know, kinaru, and then provide drinking water, kudithanneer. So kudithanneer ku thevaiyana aadharangal enna na irukku, provide drinking water, provide drinking water. Then constructing the roads, then roads alla proper ah iruka illa manal made ah iruka, so that they have to see it, and constructing the roads and maintaining them, constructing the roads, and they also has to maintain and maintaining adha vandu constructing the roads, and then setting up the sewage channels, kalvaigal, set up the sewage channels, kalivu neer kalvaigal solvom illaya, so that channels, sewage channels they have to see, and then repairing the primary school buildings and then providing the sanitation facilities. So primary school buildings and the sanitation facilities, all they have to see. Okay children, we will see it in the next class. Thank you.